In this video, I would like to demonstrate you a methodology for solving an exemplary typical hydraulic problem that uses Bernoulli's equation for an ideal fluid. The methodology includes the implementation of just four simple steps. Before moving on to the specific task, let me remind you what the four steps were and in what sequence they should be performed. So let me read it. As an additional step zero, it is included an action where all parameters from the input data should be converted into their basic measuring units. Step one, the so-called known parameters, including the processing of all required calculation, instead of using the Bernoulli's equation, which is establishing a relationship between velocity and flow rate, as for this aim, the equation of continuity is used. For the case of real fluids, there is another action that has to be done here, which is the estimation of the energy loss, but this is valid only for case of real fluids. The second step is the selection of sections, where first two sections are selected and their locations are shown on the diagram. The parameters absolute pressure, velocity, and geodetic height concerning each section should be determined. Step three is to take the Bernoulli equation from the list of equations that you used. So just copy and paste this equation. And the last step four is the replacing in the equation. It has to be used the data of step two, and after replacing in the equation, it should be solved according to the unknown parameter. The application of these steps is explained in detail in a previous video tutorial, which you can watch at the link provided. Information about the video is also given in its content below. So now let's move on to the specific task. The left on the slide, it's presented the sample scheme of the task, and on the right, it's given the input data, the information provided in advance. A fluid transport system is presented where the transported cold water is specified to be considered as an ideal fluid. The water is transported from an open tank through a pipeline with a diameter D1 equal to 60 millimeters. At the end of the pipeline, it is mounted a nozzle with a narrowing of the cross section, whose diameter is D2 equal to 20 millimeters. Just before the nozzle, a manometer is installed, with the help of which it is planned to measure the relevant manometric pressure PM at the connection or so-called joint point. It is known that the distance measured in a vertical direction from the water level in the tank to the outlet of the nozzle is h equal to 6 meters. Since the transported working fluid is cold water, its density will be equal to 1000 kg per cubic meter. As in the previous video tutorial, I suggest you now to perform the preliminary step, the so-called step zero, related to the conversion of parameters into their basic measuring units. In this case, these are only the diameters D1 and D2. Their conversion is presented on the slide. The task requires for two parameters to be determined. These are flow rate of the transported water flow, the manometric pressure PM measured at the joint point where the manometer is installed. The first step, according to the proposed methodology, is to establish a relationship between velocity and flow rate, which may be performed by applying the equation of continuity. However, in this case, this is impossible because there is no information about the flow rate Q and at least one of the two velocities. This is the so-called reverse type task, which requires step one from the first to become the last. To make it completely clear, this action is illustrated and presented on the slide. So, in this case, we go directly to step two, in which it's necessary to select the two sections for which we further must apply the Bernoulli equation. Here you can feel some hesitation where exactly to choose them. It's logical for some of you to assume that one section should be at the connection joint point of the manometer, but this would be a wrong suggestion. The idea is that when you apply Bernoulli's equation to any two sections, that there must be at most one unknown parameter after the substitution. Otherwise, there is no way to solve it. If you choose for the section the joint point of the manometer, only in this section there will be two unknown parameters: the required manometric pressure PM and the relevant velocity in the section, respectively, corresponding to the velocity of the water flow in the main pipe. To avoid any possibility of making a mistake when selecting sections, just remember the unofficial rule that was used in the previous video. All you need to do is to follow the two ends of the height H, which takes you to where the two sections need to be selected. In this case, this will be section 00. It is selected at the free level of the water in the tank, and section 2, which is selected at the nozzle's output. Be sure to indicate the locations on these sections on the diagram as presented in the sample scheme of the slide. At a later stage, section 1-1, that can be seen here, will also be selected, because it has to be used in determining the required manometric pressure. The following action is related to the description of the operating parameters in the pre-selected sections, which I propose to perform in combination for both. The determination of the absolute pressure for the two sections is performed taking into account their specific features. For section 00, as the tank is open, only atmospheric pressure acts, which means that P0 will be equal to P atmosphere. Since it is clear from the diagram that the water leaves the pipe flowing freely into the atmosphere, for the pressure in section 22, we can take into account that its determination will be analogous, similar to that in section 00, which means at the outlet of the pipe, in this case the nozzle, only the atmospheric pressure acts. So, once again, P2 will be equal to P atmosphere. The velocity in section 00 will be equal to zero. It is known and should be remembered as a rule to always apply it in such cases that the velocity in the uppermost liquid layer, also known as the free liquid level in the tank, is reliably low, insignificant, which means it is assumed that V0 is approximately equal to 0 meters per second. The velocity in section 22 is the unknown parameter that we will determine after the solution of Bernoulli's equation applied to the two selected sections is performed, which means that we can put a question mark here. To determine the values of Z for both sections, I'll first remind you the rule that was discussed in the previous video tutorial. For the section that is closer to the Earth's surface, Z is equal to zero. And for the section that is farther away from it, Z is equal to H. In this case, closer to the ground is section 22, which means that Z0 will be equal to h equal to 6 meters. Value is taken from the input data. And Z2 will be equal to 0. So, performing the third step involves only to copy and paste Bernoulli's equation for an ideal fluid on your paper sheet, as demonstrated on the slide. I pay attention again, but in Bernoulli's equation, in the form in which we use it, energy is represented in the form of heat. It's time now to move forward to the performing of step 4, which represents using the data from step 2 into substituting in Bernoulli's equation. I will continue to advise you to always make the initial substitution alphabetical instead of numerical, as presented on the slide. The parameters colored in red are to be read off, which leads for the equation to be simplified. After removing the unnecessary terms of the equation, the following expression, final equation, is obtained, the solution of which must be accomplished in respect to the unknown parameter. In this case, this is the velocity v2. This is followed by the numerical substitution, after which the unknown velocity is calculated. In this case, the velocity of the outlet of the nozzle will be 10.85 meters per second. It is now possible to implement step 1, which was initially missed. How this happens is demonstrated on the next slide. The so-called relationship between velocity and flow rate requires the performing of two actions. First, to calculate the flow rate Q in the system. Second, to determine the velocity V1 in the main pipe. For now, no one wants us to look for this velocity, but we will need it in the final calculation of the required, still unknown, manometric pressure PM. The flow rate is calculated by applying the equation of continuity presented on the slide. The symbols are now replaced with their numerical values, and thus for the required flow rate, it is obtained that it will be 0.0034 cubic meter per second, which represents 3.4 liters per second. The calculation of the velocity V1 is also done from the equation of continuity. And in this case, there are already two options for this. One is to calculate it by using the flow rate, and the second is to establish a relationship between the two velocities, knowing in advance the diameters of the pipe and the outlet of the nozzle. The second option is selected, and the equation used is presented on the slide. It is replaced by numbers, then it is calculated, and thus it becomes clear the velocity in the first pipe will be V1 equal to 1.21 meters per second. To determine the unknown parameter, the required manometric pressure PM, a new selection of sections is needed, for which to apply the Bernoulli equation one more time. The first section, marked 1-1 on the diagram, must be at the joint point of the manometer, while the second section can again be the outlet of the nozzle. Be marked as section 2-2. The determination of the main parameters for the two sections is as follows. For section 1-1, the absolute pressure is presented as the sum of the atmospheric pressure and the required manometric pressure, which means that P1 is the sum of P atmosphere and PM. The velocity is V1 equal to 1.21 meters per second, calculated in advance. and Z1 is equal to 0. I will pay special attention to the definition of Z in this case. For section 2, the absolute pressure is equal to the atmospheric one. It has already been discussed on it in the previous selection of sections, as section 2.2 was one of the two selected ones. The velocity is V2 equal to 10.85 meters per second, precalculated, and Z2 is equal to 0 again. Now, let us explain why in this case it is assumed that the geodetic heights Z1 and Z2 are equal to 0 for both sections. I'll try to explain it by using the diagram presented on the next slide. The determination of the geodetic height is performed in the way demonstrated in the sample diagram. It is known that, by definition, the geodetic height is the distance measured in the vertical direction between the Earth's surface and the center of the selected section. It can be seen that even if the two pipes connected in series, in this case a pipe and a nozzle, have different diameters or different cross-sectional areas, since the pipeline is located in a horizontal direction, their centers lie on the same horizontal line that is parallel to the Earth's surface, which means that the distances describing, characterizing the geodetic heights will be the same. It is like drawing perpendiculars between two parallel lines. Since Z1 and Z2 are the same, it's easier to assume them equal to 0 and to get rid of Z directly when substituting in Bernoulli's equation. In conclusion, the only exception to the general rule discussed in the previous video tutorial, which aims to explain how quickly determine Z equal to 0 and H for the two sections, is when the pipeline is horizontal like given in this case. Then both Z's are equal to 0. Next is to copy and paste the Bernoulli equation for ideal fluids, which once again happens by using the relevant application with the equations used in solving such problems. Now it's time to substitute in the equation as demonstrated on the slide. For this purpose, use the data from the step in which the parameters of the two sections involved in the equation itself were described. Get rid of unnecessary members, those colored in red. After performing elementary mathematical operations, the alphabetical solution of the problem is displayed. The moment comes when the numerical substitution takes place. After calculating this expression, the final answer to the problem is obtained, namely, the required manometric pressure will be 58,129.2 pascals, which is almost 58.13 kilopascals.